The question that we need to put in our mind, did that 16 or 17 days that has gone, have we actually benefited from the month of Ramadan? Has our Qiyam and our Siyam done properly for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal? What guarantee do we have that they're going to be acceptable in the eyes of Allah? Have we rectified our relation with Allah Azza wa Jal in these 15 days that passed by? Have we benefited in Ramadan? We were waiting for Ramadan. We spoke about the preparation of Ramadan. Have we actually got the sweetness of Iman, the sweetness of Siyam and Qiyam in the past 15 days of Ramadan? This is a question mark that we need to put in our mind after each and every day has passed. Sheikh bin Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he said the second part of Ramadan is better than the first part, which means the second 10 days of Ramadan is better than the first 10 days of Ramadan, and the last 10 days of Ramadan is better than the first and second 10 days of Ramadan. Dear brothers and sisters, Ramadan is going to come to an end, and we do not know that we're going to be among the people who are accepted or the people who are rejected. Successful are those people who meet Ramadan and gain its bounties and has his sins forgiven. Losers are those, and cursed are those, according to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, those who has passed the month of Ramadan, فَلَمْ يُغْفَرْ لَهُ, and their deeds and the bad deeds has not been forgiven. Those are the losers in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jal. How do you fall into this trap? There are people who enter the month of Ramadan and they actually take Ramadan as a kind of culture. There are people who enter the month of Ramadan and they don't care. The only thing that you see them doing is just abstaining from food and drink and desire. They don't care, they lie, they backbite, they swear, they curse, they do not lower their gaze. These kind of people, Allah is not in need of them abstaining from their food and drink, according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There are people now who are still thinking that I haven't been touched by Ramadan yet. There are people nowadays who are still thinking that when is Eid, we want to finish with this. But at the same time, there are people whose tears fall are those people who believe that they might not reach the next Ramadan. One day in the month of Ramadan, the deeds, that the achievement that you may get in one day, you may not get that in the rest of the month. If now 16 or 17 of Ramadan, you do not rectify yourself and you're like, now, the other thing that I did not do, I took as easy. Some Salatul Fajr, I never went. Some Salatul Maghrib, I sit at home, I made iftar. I still not ready to wear my hijab. My five daily prayer is still not yet in the masjid. If you are into these kind of people, it is time for you to rectify yourself, brothers and sisters. Ramadan is coming to an end. It just started. We said last time, a guest comes and it goes, and the guest is about to go. And what guarantee do we have that we're going to live until the next of Ramadan? What guarantee do we have that we're going to live until tomorrow and after tomorrow? This is what we need to think about. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was known as qanit, as an obedient person, someone khashi', concentrated, and someone fearful to Allah Azza wa Jal. What is the meaning of qanit? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ, and stand in front of Allah qanit. Is standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla with concentration. Is standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jalla knowing that this could be your last salah. A qanit is someone who is obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we are not going to get ourselves to this level in Ramadan, when are we going to get that? When the shaitan comes out, it ain't gonna work. The time for us to be able to get ourselves to the level where we want is in Ramadan. It is a season where we can get our Miftah al-Jannah, the key of Jannah. If we don't try to get that now, when you think we're gonna get that? When Shaitan comes outside in Shawwal, it's not gonna work. Who are the Qanit? The Qanitun are those people who wake up in the night. They stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. They prostrate and they bow down when other people are sleeping. This is one of the significant meaning of Qanit. Qanit means khushur. Qanit means to have concentration and to be fearful of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He speaks about the people who praise the Qiyam al-Layl. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَاسْجُدْ لَهُ وَسَبِّحُ لَيْلًا طَوِيلًا كَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ There are people who in the night, when other people are sleeping, they get up. For whose sake? For the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Can anyone see you when you're waking up for Salat al-Tahajjud? Wallahi, no one except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the beginning when he went to Medina Munawwara. When he said about the people who will enter Jannah, Afshu al-Salam, wa at'imu al-Ta'am, wasalu al-Arham, wa sallu bil-layli wa nasu niyam. Among the people who will enter Jannah, تدخل الجنة بسلام. People who will enter Jannah, give food, give salam, reconciliate, and pray while people are sleeping. And this is what we are going to focus on in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And this is what we do when we have actually hit the last 10 nights of Ramadan, which is in the Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. And that night, it is better than 1,000 months. So any good deed that you do in the Laylatul Qadr, it will take you 1,000 months and more to do that deed. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he would make i'tikaf in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. The sole reason would be to seek the Laylatul Qadr. It is in the last 10 nights of Ramadan, in the odd nights of Ramadan. And that is why we speak about Qanit, because it is the time where we all know that we're going to focus on the Qiyam al-Layl. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, إِنَّ إِبْرَاهِيمَ كَانَ أُمَّةً قَانِتًا لِلَّهِ For verily Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, he was an ummah. He came alone. When he started preaching monotheism, he came alone. Allah called him an ummah. Qanitan lillah. He used to devote himself in the night. Allah Azza wa Jal tell in the Quran, Ya Maryam qunutini rabbiki wasjudi warka'i ma'al raki'in. O Maryam, uqnuti. Be concentrated, be someone who is fearful in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jal, especially in the night when people are sleeping. Majority of the prophets, they devoted themselves in the night. And this is what we're going to do in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. And it's approaching in 3 to 5 nights. And what are the deeds that we may do in this last 10 nights of Ramadan? As-sadaqah. Qiyam al-Layl, reconciliating. Whoever gives one sadaqah, to say the clever people are those people who each and every night of the last 10 nights of Ramadan, they give sadaqah, it could be 1 dirham. So you imagine that 1 dirham coincided with Laylatul Qadr, it will be as if you have given sadaqah khayrun min alf shahr. And if you have given sadaqah for more than 1,000 months, almost 83 years and 4 months, Allahu Akbar. These are the things that we need to prepare for. And these are the things that we need to regret for. That 15 days has gone, and still I did not see any changement in my life. I did not see any kind of changement between me and my relation with Allah Azza wa Jal. I still lie. I'm still not wearing the hijab. I'm still smoking. I'm still raising my voice. There's still marital discord in my family. There's something wrong. Your qareen is very strong. We know that in Ramadan, the shayateen are chained. But the sin that you're committed, it is the qareen that you have in you. By the way, we are all born by a qareen. A qareen is someone that actually make you prone to fall into sin. A jinn, a shaytan, that is with you day and night. But for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, as for my qareen, he became a Muslim. He tell me to do everything good. But as for us, that qareen always tells us to do something bad. But we cannot make the qareen that strong, that even in Ramadan, we're not able to lower our gaze. Even in Ramadan, we're still lying. Even in Ramadan, we tend to still cheat in our business. Just put in your mind, if I am not going to change in Ramadan, when will I change? Because there's no guarantee that we are going to meet the next of Ramadan. هذا والله تعالى أعلم أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. الله عز وجل, he speaks about Ramadan and الصيام in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah. And after that Allah says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. For verily when my slave are asking about me, Ya Rasulullah, tell them that I am near to them. الدعاء, brothers and sisters. It is the weapon of the Muslim. الدعاء. It is the biggest ni'mah that you may have, only for those people who knows. This is the time when we raise our hand in the last part of the night. And when we're making our hand like this, we're actually resembling a beggar, begging Allah Azza wa Jal for His mercy and for His forgiveness. And this is what we need to do whenever we make dua, brothers and sisters, that we know that Allah Azza wa Jal is going to accept our dua. Ud'u Allah wa antum muqinoon bil ijaba. Make dua to Allah Azza wa Jal, knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa sami', Allah the all hearer, al mujib. Allah Azza wa Jal, He will respond to your dua. It might not be now, your response could be delayed, either in the dunya or in the akhirah. Brothers and sisters, اليوم يوم الجمعة. Today is the day of Jum'ah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, among the three people that their dua are not rejected are the people who are fasting, like us now. We ask Allah to accept it. But it does not have to be just before iftar. You can start making dua after fajr. You can make dua now. You can make dua anytime during the day, especially before iftar. The dua that not are rejected, as well as Yawm al-Jum'ah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the time in Yawm al-Jum'ah, that it is small. And not many people get that time, except those people whom Allah Azza wa Jal chooses. And whoever make dua in this time, Allah Azza wa Jal will accept that. And then it is said, it is before the Adhan al-Maghrib. Or after Salat al-Fajr, after Salat al-Asr, from Asr until Maghrib. The dua that you make on Yawm al-Jum'ah, it is accepted. You imagine you are in Ramadan, you are fasting, the shayateen are chained, and it is Yawm al-Jum'ah. Don't let 2 days after Salat al-Asr just go like that. Make sure you spend at least 5 to 10 minutes. Raise your hand to Allah Azza wa Jal and ask Allah whatever you want. For verily Allah huwa al-ghani, whatever you ask, nothing decrees from His kingdom and nothing decrees from His sustenance.